Yeah, interesting. GDPR is a general data protection regulation. Now, this came into existence on the 25th of May 2018, which is like a few weeks back only. This is a regulation which basically takes the interest of the consumer and data attached to a consumer. Important thing for the consumer now, for the first time, they have an ability to protect their data and have complete control of the data as well. So, in case that any of the platform who was taking data from you till this time now has to compulsorily ask for a permission before they actually take it outside. So now you have an ability to take care of your own data and probably protect it yourself. I'll give in a consumer language, what are we talking about? In a consumer language, let's say for example that you had a date, you had a picture. In a layman's perspective, I'm talking about, you had a picture which you had taken when you were a kid. Now that picture, you used it 10 years back on a social media platform. Now you suddenly come across that picture and you probably felt that this picture is not appropriate for me. Now you have an ability to actually get it deleted and ask for deletion, which will not appear at any other place at all. So now this gives you an ability to protect your own data and take action as per your own choice. So that's the GDPR in nutshell about right now.
So basically what you're trying to tell me is that GDPR is protecting the right to privacy of citizens in European Union.
Yeah.
Right. So then why everybody else around the world is so worried?
So let me just clarify this. This has been, GDPR has been introduced in European Union and UK to start with. Now this is where they have started with, but it's going to be spread across the world. And of course, the first thing which is going to happen is that GDPR, although it has been constrained to those geographies, but those geographies are also sharing data across the world. It's a global village. Now anybody who's communicating with those countries or has business in those countries have also to comply with it. Now let me tell you what happens in GDPR. If in case an organization has not complied to the GDPR thing, then there are huge fines related to that. The fines are to the extent of 4% of your global revenue can be taken out, and to the extent of 25 or 20 million pounds is what is the minimum. So whatever is higher is what will be fined to you. So people or companies have to be cautious in terms of what they are now giving it and what access they are giving it to people and what data are they collecting it. So they are more responsible right now.
Okay, so coming to the third question, Pankaj, if you would like to address it, what is the impact of GDPR on digital advertising, marketing and data supported agencies?
Right, so the fact is that with this GDPR regulation coming, a lot of these big advertising spenders do work in the European Union market, the EU market. So they are going to take a lot of time in ensuring that their product services are compliant with the entire GDPR. Now this is not an easy exercise. This is going to take a while, because this will include automation, artificial intelligence, machine learning, because the norms that have been created by the GDPR are quite stringent. So they, and because of the fact that they are working in those EU nation, they cannot just take it easy the way probably it was or this came into being. So with why this is happening, the revenues that are the spends that are happening on the advertising are going to take a hit till the time everything is in place and they're becoming compliant. So I think this is going to affect the advertising pie to a certain extent for a while.
So was there no regulation earlier? I mean, consent has always been something that everybody has been talking about around the world.
Sure.
Then why are companies suddenly scared of having presence in European Union, not being compliant to GDPR? I mean,
I think the first thing that comes to mind, Nishant, that why is everybody scared is because, as Jay said, fines. We're talking about 20 million pounds and 4% of annual global turnover. Now, coming back to the question that you just mentioned, that were there not norms in place earlier before the GDPR came into being? That's not entirely true. The fact is, India, while it may not have a separate sort of bill for data privacy, however, the IT Act, Section 43A, clearly defines, protects the data privacy of citizens of our country. And the fines that have been put in under those sections are quite huge. In fact, up to 5 crores, which I believe are among the highest even across IPC. So those are quite stringent. So it's just that because most of the big players across the world are going to be impacted with GDPR and India, because we have embarked on this monumental digital journey where we are talking about 25 billion digital transactions in the coming financial year. So obviously this is going to impact all the big players. That's why everybody's talking about it, to make sure that nothing goes wrong, because these players are not only working in India but also working in the EU sphere.
And Joy, if you would like to answer this, many Indian publications, including Economic Times, ET Prime, that they just launched a subscription-based portal. As soon as GDPR was enforced, even they stopped their subscription in European Union. So is it something that they are doing wrong? And something that's grossly wrong in how they are collecting data? That's first point. And second is, how big is the impact of the GDPR compliance in Indian media industry? How big the impact is?
It is not that they were not compliant earlier. It is not that they were not doing anything to protect the data of people as well. It is just that there was a deadline set, which was 25th of May. And there is too much at stake. So it is a cautious approach which not just the Indian companies, across the world people are taking. Mm-hmm. Now, what they're doing is very simple. For the timing, they're taking off a few things just to ensure that whatever other, it's a new thing, so they need to take time to understand and then accordingly act. They don't want to make mistakes which will actually put them into trouble. So what they are trying to do is basically taking more time to understand what are the requirements, make it compliant, ensuring that the data team talks to the compliance team, they come up with a solution, and then solution is something which has been given. So in the interest of longer run, they are taking a hit currently to ensure that they're not available, but over a period of time when they're already compliant to GDPR, they will come back again and probably do that. Now, that's an opportunity as well. Remember, the opportunity is like this. If there are GDPR compliant companies who are actually now able to take care of the compliant issues completely, and they're confident about it, that actually will be preferred in European markets or across the world as well. That gives you a positive thing as well. So I'm hoping that all the Indian companies are now looking forward to get GDPR compliant and then come back and then release it.
So basically what you are trying to tell me is that although the companies are sort of afraid of huge penalties right now, but this might actually turn out to be big opportunity for the Indian market.
Absolutely. Pankaj, what's your thought on this one?
Right. Okay. So there are a couple of things, Nishant. I mean, as Jay rightly took us into the right direction, that this is not only a huge risk, but it also can turn out to be a great advantage. However, I want to first touch base upon the first question that you answered, that why are suddenly companies slightly more cautious or have taken down certain things that were dealing with the European market? Now, the biggest challenge is to understand for any of the CXOs of these big organizations is that they have been collecting data because they've been working in those spheres for the longest time now. And now with the GDPR coming in and the fines being so huge and the penalties being so steep, they have to first do a assessment of the data that they have been collecting so far. Because the flow of data is huge, not only just in terms of numbers, but the entire transit of data within the organization is quite complex. So if you ask just any CXO that can you tell me where this data of this EU citizen is there, I don't think any CXO agent would be able to answer that, because the entire flow of data within any organization is quite complex. So these people, why they have taken it down is because to buy time, understand what's for dual gap assessment, that where is the data that they've been collecting, what is happening to that data, where is it, and what is that organization currently doing with it, right? So once they understand this, once they have done this assessment, then they can figure out a way to structure it to, within the norms of the GDPR. Now this, I've said it in probably two lines, but you also understand, Michelle, this is not as easy as it sounds. This is quite complex, so this is going to take a while. And the fact is that the repercussion of not taking this, doing this exercise the result of that could end up, you know, in huge fines. This is the reason why all these companies are, you know, have taken this cautious approach, and rightly so. You know, it makes sense. Now, coming back to the opportunity, as Jay mentioned, that if you are compliant, what can it do for you? Now, you know, just, you know, a little while ago I mentioned that, you know, the India is a digitally enabled economy. At least that's where we're trying to go. We're talking about huge number of digital transactions in the financial year. And now with obviously the Supreme Court ruling that privacy also is a fundamental right, you know, it's important in India as well. It's not only because of GDPR. You know, our IT Act also talks about the same. Now, how is this not right? Right, so I was talking about that now India is obviously, you know, is working towards being a digitally enabled economy. We're talking about aiming at billions of digital transactions in the coming financial year. And also on top of that, the Supreme Court recently, you know, when the entire Aadhaar hearing was happening, Supreme Court ruled that privacy is a fundamental right of citizens of India as well. So it is not only GDPR that is making companies look out for data privacy and its related laws. It's also because India has not broken up, right? Because the IT Act has always been there. But the fact, the importance of the entire, you know, data and how it is being dealt with, it has important. Now, why is this an opportunity? I think this is where I was going before we got cut off. Look at data is like the new oil. Data is the biggest currency, and that is how we are looking at it. And in India, the biggest organizations, the sectors like IT, IT services, all companies working in the entire outsourcing sphere, call centers, data management, whatever it is, you know, they are working very closely with the entire, you know, EU space, along with the telecom, banking, life sciences, pharma, whatever. You know, so these companies have invested huge amounts of money so that, you know, they can get some sort of term by working with the EU. Now with the GDPR coming in, they would want to work with organizations who are GDPR compliant, because they are not so stringent. They have created those laws, so they will ensure that they work with the best of the people. Now, this presents a huge opportunity for Indian organizations who are already working with the EU citizens in whatever manner. If they are able to become GDPR compliant, that could provide like a first mover advantage, so to speak, in that space, which could give them competitive advantage in the space, because this is going to become a norm, especially in the EU, right? Because they would want to work with companies who are GDPR compliant completely. So yeah, this presents a huge opportunity for these, you know, organizations. Yeah.
So while I understand what you're trying to say is that, okay, now European Union would be looking for companies that are GDPR compliant, and therefore companies would be, you know, making themselves compliant to GDPR. But what about other governments of other nations? How do you think other countries are they going to wake up to it? Are they going to come up with their own regulations? How is it going to work out for other countries? Because like you said, data is the new oil. I mean, everybody wants more and more data. It has made things so different so easy for everybody. How do you think it's going to affect other countries? Do you think they're going to wake up to it, or what's going to happen?
This GDPR is not a benchmark that the European Union has set.
Yep.
Now, you're right that I think most of the countries because data has been something which has been the minds, and the economies are being affected by data in the past 5 to 7 years for sure, even smaller economies. So now, let's say India, for example, as I said, we might not have a separate IT Act, IT Bill, but we have an IT Act 43A which talks very clearly about data. But on top of that, if you look at within India itself, there has been a huge debate about the IT Bill, so to speak. You know, what should be included, what should not be included. I'm sure a lot of it would be taken from the GDPR to ensure that if these are, because, you know, European Union comes up with the most stringent when it comes to data privacy. It's all with setting the, you know, benchmark for that. So a lot of guidelines could be taken from there, that this is how they are protecting the data rights of their citizens. I'm sure that Indian laws and other countries' new laws would also be created or legislated based on similar sort of guidelines to ensure.
Sir, would you like to add something on how important protection of data is and where do we stand in terms of protection of data as a nation?
See, it's very simple. We are a country of 1 billion people, which is like a good percentage of the world population. And we are a democratic country. You know, you need to ensure, you know, as a country, the data needs to be protected for an individual. It's important for us to have laws where individual data is completely taken care of. Now, I am of the opinion that yes, GDPR is a first, in a good step towards that direction. And we should have, you know, India coming up with probably the similar regulations where it is difficult for people to go away, you know, when they are able to take the data. Now, there should not be any leakages at all, because understand that if in case the data is misused, now that can lead to a lot of complex situations as well. So to ensure that we protect the interest of individuals and citizens of the country, we have to come up with regulations or things which are going to protect, which are going to ensure that people believe in what they are giving it to you is going to be protected. So that's where it will.
Do you think there's a long way to go as a country?
I think we are a country which is very pro IT. We understand this better. In fact, as Pankaj rightly pointed out, that there are already laws available which protects the interest of individuals as well. I don't think we are very far. It is a matter of now, the country coming together to put a framework in place in executing it. So I'm not sure it's too far. I think we are very close to coming close to the GDPR as well.
Thank you so much, Gautam. It was great talking to you guys. Thank you.